there's the short-term answer, and then there's sort of the longer-term answer. The short-term answer, looking at the companies that have done the best in the last, let's say, 1 year or 3 years, have been companies that are most aggressively buying back their stock, where there haven't been as many active managers, and there's been fewer passive flows in the last, let's say, year or 18 months or so into oil and gas equities. It's been the companies that have been sort of picking up the shares and being sort of that marginal buyer that it seems have had the best performance, with a couple of exceptions where they're sort of super high growth companies. Some of them are new issues. And so from a longer term perspective, I think the data shows very clearly the best returns over the long term are for companies that grow their per share cash flow and per share net asset value. And so how that's returned, whether that's through reinvestment or whether that's through dividends or buybacks, I think the data is sort of mixed on that. But longer term, it's about per share NAV and per share cash flow growth. And in the short term, it's been, in the last year to 3 years, really the companies that have bought back the most stock that have seen the most share appreciation. And again, oddly, even companies that have been issuers of their stock to go and do acquisitions, as long as they then turned around and been buyers in the market, and again, the math is sort of fuzzy on that, and there's probably not a lot of value creation, those have been the shares that have appreciated the most in the last year or two.